الحمد لله الحمد لله مذهب السيئات بالحسنات وغافر الخطيئات بالطاعات والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. All praise due to Allah and His praise and blessings and peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, his family, his companions, and his followers until the Day of Judgment. I bear witness that Allah is the only one worthy of worship, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, his last and final messenger. My dear brothers and sisters, يقول الله تعالى قل لكم ميعاد يوم لا تستأخرون عنه ساعة ولا تستقدمون. Allah have appointed for us a specific time. When that time comes, you cannot extend your life in this life, or you can die before your time. ستفضي بك الأيام في بعض مرها إلى ساعة لا ساعة لك بعدها. A person, every day, the days and the moments, the months and the years, just carrying you to your destinies. And when you arrive to that point where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have decided for you, that's where you have no way to return. At that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. Fear the day when you will return to your Lord and you will be held accountable for your deeds. You will be recompensed for what you have done. At that day, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. When a person at that day will run away from all his family members, brothers, children, spouses, parents. Why? لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنُ يُغْنِيهِ. Because each and everyone at that day is occupied with his own self. في صحيح مسلم that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that in that day every mother and every father and every parents and every children, when they meet their parents or their children and they ask for their help, they say, we can't offer you any help. Even Isa ibn Maryam, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, Mary will tell him, يا عيسى, I'm your mother. And he will say, أمه لا أغني عنك اليوم من الله شيئا. I can't help you with anything. وفي الصحيح أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم brought his family, and he brought Fatima رضي الله عنها, his beloved daughter, and he said, يا فاطمة, سلين اليوم ما شئتي فإني لا أغني عنك يوم القيامة من الله شيئا. Whatever you want, ask me now, because the day of judgment, you can't ask me anything. I can't help you with anything in the day of judgment. At that day, the only winners are the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved from hellfire and enter Jannah. كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز. Then in that day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, telling us, those who will be saved from hellfire and enter Jannah are the one who attain success. They are the real successful. And there is no way you will be saved from hellfire and enter Jannah unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy reach you and also your deeds. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that in that day, our deeds are weighted. The good deeds and the bad deeds. And those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them. and accept from them and make their deeds, their good deeds, overweight the bad deeds, they are the one who will be saved from the hellfire. وَالْوَزْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْحَقِّ فَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. So the true losers of that day are the one who will lose themselves to the hellfire. Why? Because the side of their good deeds is light. خَفَّتْ. Their good deeds is very, the side and the scale of their good deeds is very light. Why? It's for two reasons. لماذا خفت أعمالهم الصالحة? One, it's because their bad deeds way more than their good deeds. So it looks very light. Or because literally they didn't come with much. They didn't offer much. And obviously, they definitely didn't offer much if their bad deeds will overweight to their good deeds. So if this is the case, and we are in the month of good deeds, we are the month of the righteous deeds. We're the month where the gates of paradise widely open and the gates of hellfire are closed and the shayateen are chained. All this for what? It's just to encourage you to do more good. And if you notice, in Ramadan, we do more good than any other month, in any other nights, in any other days. Alhamdulillah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be like that as well. So there is no surprise. And one of the reasons that we take advantage of this time, so we can increase basically our saving from the good deeds. And whatever the time permit me, I want to share with you a very interesting concept in Islam, which is the good deeds versus bad deeds. And how the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ speaks about this concept in a way that makes you so committed to do just more and more and more as much as you can. And the first principle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, and the Muhammad ﷺ explained this in many ways, that there is a very interesting rule that any good deed you do, it will be counted for you as 10. As a starting point. أي حسنة تعملها تعد وتحسب لك عشرة فأكثر. So any good deeds you do, it will be written not as one, it will be written 10 and up. 10 and more. So you start from 10. But in the other hand, any bad deeds you do, it will be only written one. So basically, the ratio of your surviving is 1 to 10. Because every time you do one good deed, that's 10 and more. The minimum sin. And any time you do bad deeds, that's only one sin that you have committed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ عَشْرُ أَمْثَالِهَا وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ. Those who come with good deeds, they will have 10. And those who will come with bad deeds, فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا. It will be count as one single bad deed. وفي حديث ابن عباس في الصحيحين رضي الله عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله تعالى, that Allah said in the hadith القدسي في البخاري مسلم, if my servant, he telling the angel, have the intention to do something good and he do it, write it for him 10 rewards. اكتبوا له اكتبوها عشرة اكتبوها عشرة. It will be written 10 for the person. Once the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم came to the companions and said to them, is it too hard for you to earn 2,500 hasana a day? 2,500. So they thought that that means they have to do 2,500 good deeds. So they, maybe it's quite, you know, challenging for some, for many. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, after you finish your salah, you say Subhanallah 10 times, Alhamdulillah 10 times, Allahu Akbar 10 times, 5 times a day. That's 150 with your tongue and 1,500 in your skill. And the Prophet ﷺ, he's the one who's saying that. And before you go to sleep, well, before you sleep, you say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. That's 100 with the tongue and 1,000 in your skill on the Day of Judgment. 1,000 in your record. So the total will be 2,500 just for these two simple things. Just for these 2,500. Then in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam raised a very interesting question. He said, and who among you commit 2,500 sins a day? Which is a very interesting concept. He wants to make you aware of how many good deeds you can accumulate. We did not count yet Salatul Jumu'ah, Salatul Jama'ah, the prayer, the five daily prayer. We didn't count Assalamu Alaikum, Wa Alaikum Assalam. We didn't count your Sadaqah. We didn't touch anything yet of the fara'il. Just these two simple tasks or two simple deeds you can do, that's 2,500 deeds a day. وفي صحيح مسلم عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من حديث أبي ذر قال من عمل حسنة فله عشر أمثالها أو أزيد ومن عمل سيئة فجزاؤه مثلها أو أغفرها. الله أكبر. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم that Allah said if you do good deeds it will be 10 or more and if you do bad deeds it will be 1 or I will forgive. And the two options, it even can be forgiven. And as you hear, that it can be more. As you know, there are certain deeds, I'm sure you heard, especially in Ramadan, we hear this a lot, that multiplied to 700 double when it's come to your sadaqah. So, al-ulama rahimahullah discussed the issue, how can your deeds will be multiplied more than even 10? How can your deeds, not only 10, it will be more than 10? The ulama rahimahullah said, there are certain factors will affect how much your deeds can be multiplied. Number one, the time. So you do good deeds in Ramadan, that's more reward diligence than any regular day. So if it's a regular day, it's 10, and Ramadan it's more. In Laylatul Qadr, it's way more than any nights of Ramadan. You know, at the time of fitan, when it's hard, the time where the situation is tough for you to hold into the sunnah, the ajr is more. That's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, at the end of the days, one of the people in the end of the days who holding to the religion, his reward equal to 50 of the companions. 50 of the Prophet ﷺ companions. قال أجره أجر خمسين منكم القابض على ديني في آخر الزمان. So the time play a role, praying in the end of the night, different than the beginning of the night. Fasting the long days when it is hot and you know it's tough, different than that, basically the short days. Giving sadaqah, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the best form of sadaqah, the one that you give when you're still healthy, when you're still young, you have the life ahead of you. Versus the one who gave the sadaqah at the end of his life. And that's maybe more to the second point, which is the situation that you doing the good deeds while you're in. So if you are, for example, you're doing good deeds, it depends on your situation, how much ikhlas, how much sincerity you have when you do the good deeds. You want to tell me that the reward will be equal for someone when he stands before Allah and finish his salah, he doesn't know even what he prayed, will be equal to someone who contemplate, think about every movement of his salah or her salah, about the verses that was recited. Will be equal the one who read the Quran just because he memorized it, and the one who read the Quran because he understand it. There is difference. So the person, the situation that you're in, how much you are, have ikhlas, focus, khushu' will determine how far your deeds will go. Also, one of the factors that will determine that as well is the location. So the ulama rahimahullah looked at the hadith, deeds in al-haram, salah in Mecca, 100,000 doubles. Salah in Masjid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 1,000 times doubles. In Al-Aqsa, 500 times double. In this, in any masjid, it's 27 times doubles. So the place play also a role in multiplying. And also the ulama said, the one who hold into his deen, give da'wah, and practice the religion in place where they live as minority, when the challenge is hard and tough, when you give da'wah and make al-amr al-ma'ruf and na'i al-munkar, when you give nasiha in a land when you don't have a supporter, it's not like someone live in a land where all Muslims and everybody, you know, doing the right thing. So the land and the place also play a role in how much your reward will be multiplied. Then finally, the deed itself. Some deeds, the reward of it will not even start from 10. قال ابن عمر كل عمل لابن آدم يبدأ بعشر حسنات إلا الصدقة تبدأ بسبعمائة ضعف. Ibn Umar رضي الله عنه said, every good deed you do, it starts with 10, except charity. Charity starts with 700 and up. Another deed, قال الله تعالى, ابن آدم, anything that son of Adam, anything you do, it will be multiplied from 10 to 700. إِلَّا الصَّوْمِ. So a psalm does not even apply to these rules. It doesn't go to 10 or 700. Allah said, إِلَّا الصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِ بِهِ. يعني عدد الحسنات اللي تكتب لك في صيامك لا يعلمها إلا الله. ليس لها عدد يحصى ولا يعلمه إلا الله. That means the fasting, the reward of it is not 10, is not 700, is so huge that only Allah knows how much the reward for it will be in the Day of Judgment. What a lucky ummah we are that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have made it so easy for us like this. It is an interesting to know as well that is the bad deeds can be ever multiplied? Many of the scholars agree that will not be multiplied. But the ulama said that the sins can be more severe. The severity of the sin. One of the factor that, for example, we said is the doer of the sin can affect the sin. So the sin of the scholar, the alim, the hafiz al-Quran, the one who understands the deen, the one who represents the Muslims, will not be equal to the a person or a lame person. The sin of cheating your family member is worse than the sin of cheating just a person. That's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam قال that the worst sin, أن تزني بحليلة جارك, is to commit zina with your neighbor's wife. It's worse than any form of adultery because it's basically bigger sin and more severe sin. Also the time, sin in Ramadan is way more severe than other than Ramadan. The place, sinning in the masjid, in Mecca, that's why Ibn Abbas and many of the Sahaba avoided living in Mecca because of that reason. If you notice, not many companions lived in Mecca because they believed, some of them believed even it can be multiplied. كان ابن عباس ممن يقول بهذا. Ibn Abbas among those who believe that it can be multiplied. He said, السيئة في مكة بمئة سيئة. It will be multiplied 100 times. So then the type of sin also, the severity of it, difference. Because as you know, sins are levels, darakat. Keep that in mind, will help you to navigate your way, because all of us, we commit sins, we make mistakes. So we need to know how to navigate our life through the good deeds and the bad deeds. The second principle that I would like to share is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. That good deeds erase bad deeds. في حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الترمذي قال أتبع الحسنة السيئة تمحها. Good deeds erase bad deeds, but not the other way around. So if you do good deeds, then you do bad deeds after that, it will not erase your good deeds. You did first some, you fast Ramadan. In the night you did something wrong, haram. You will not lose your deeds that you did in the day. But if, let's say, you did sin in the daytime, and you prayed your Taraweeh, and you prayed your Isha, and you prayed your Maghrib, that will erase the sin. A man came to the Prophet ﷺ and said, Ya Rasulullah, I did a terrible thing, I committed a mistake. He said, pray two rak'ah. And he prayed and he recited, Innal hasanat yudhibna sayyi'at. Good deeds erase bad deeds. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he told them that, it was understood from the Sahaba that this is not an invitation for them to do bad deeds. It was an invitation for them to do more good because nobody is perfect. Radiallahu an Umar ibn al-Khattab. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu an, in one incident, you know, just I'm going to pick the point because it's a long story, in Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, he showed some form of objection to the Prophet and he was ashamed of himself. How can he verbally object what the Prophet said about signing the treaty with the people of Mecca? إيش قال عمر بعد ذلك؟ قال عملت لها أعمالا كالجبال. After that, I made deeds like the size of the mountains. Hopefully it will erase that sin. Because also if it's a great sin, you need a great deeds to take care of it. If it's a severe sin, you need a great deeds to take care of it. And as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, قال لا أعلم ذنب يغفره بر الوالدة. Ibn Abbas said, I don't know any sin that will stand in front of taking good care of your mother. Taking good care of your mother, that's a good deed, will wipe any sin. قال الإمام أحمد رحمه الله لا أعمل لا أعلم بعد الحج من الصالحات ما يكفر الكبائر إلا بر الوالدين. الإمام أحمد رحمه الله said, after Hajj, there is nothing wipe al-kabair out from your record like بر الوالدين, being good to your parents. So these good deeds erase the bad deeds. Just a point to be made, the sins that it will be erased are the sin that is between you and Allah. But what between you and the other humans, you have to deal with them. Yani you don't take somebody's money and you say, I'm gonna go pray two rak'ahs. No, it's like Allah khair, but yani give the money back to the to the person. Okay? If you treated somebody unfairly, if you hurt someone, so that's something else. We not talk about this type of sins. This requires from you, this is, has two sides. One side will be erased by the good deeds, but the other side, which is to the human, it has to be dealt between you and him, and either to ask forgiveness or to make it up for the person. The third one, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Furqan, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات. يا سلام. When a person repent to Allah from the bad deeds that he or she did, Allah replaces it with good deeds. If it's 1,000, it will be 1,000 reward. If it's 100, it will be 100,000 reward, 100 reward, and so forth. And it's out of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. But it would never be the other way around. If somebody was so good and أعوذ بالله انتكس or didn't practice or start doing bad things, he would never, these good deeds will remain in his record. The only time you lose it, if you commit shirk. لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. If you commit shirk, you lose your good deeds. Also, this an amazing point also to be pointed out. And it shows you the great mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That any good deeds, that you have the intention to do it, just the intention to do it, and you couldn't do it for a reason. Let's say you get sick, you get prevented from reaching there, and you seriously, and the intention is there, and you're firm about doing it, Allah give you the reward of it as if you exactly did it. You have the intention to fast, but the doctor said you can't. You take the ajr of a perfect fasting day. You have the intention to sleep, to wake up and pray. You overslept. You get the intention as if you spend the night praying. And Hajj and so forth. And if you have the intention to do something good, and you didn't do it, and listen to this, because there's a delicate difference between this, for this scenario I just said, and the second one I'm saying now. You have the intention to do something good, but you didn't do it. No, for no reason, for no valid reason. You get distracted, you forgot, you got lazy, but your intention to do it. You get the ajr of the intention. So it's a win-win situation. That's why al-fuqaha yaqulun inna al-mu'min yudriku bi niyyatihi ma la yudriku bi 'amalihi. You always can reach so far with your intention, way more than what you can do with your own deeds. While the sins, if you intend to do something bad and you didn't do it because you fear Allah, that bad intention will be forgiven and you will get reward for not doing the bad deeds. And if you intend to do something bad, but you never did it, you get distracted, you got lazy, it didn't work out, you know, the ticket got canceled, you didn't travel to Vegas, you know, let's say, whatever, you know, or you guys in the East Coast have something closer, I guess, you know. So whatever you did, you will not be sinful. La ilaha illallah. You will not be sinful for that. It will not. Because the Nabi said, مَا لَمْ يَتَكَلَّمُوا أَوْ يَعْمَلُوا. You only get sin if you said it or you did it. But if you intend to do something bad and you have the clear intention, but you by force was stopped, you get sin for the intention, but not for the deeds. So still there is a mercy. Like in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he said about the two people who fight one another and basically get sinned because they participated in the fight. Anyway, these are also one of the things that quickly we can end with, is any good deeds, any bad deeds you do it by force, you've been forced to it, or by mistakes, unintentionally, it's forgiven. It is forgiven. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaktub lana wa iyyakum min as-salihat wa yu'inna wa iyyakum ala 'amaliha. Aqulu ma sami'tum astaghfirullah li wa lakum astaghfiru. Alhamdulillah wahdahu as-salatu was-salamu ala man la nabiyya ba'dahu wa ba'd. I also talk about this subject, and especially in Ramadan. There is a very important message I wanted to go home with today. That you just heard how much reward you get by doing good deeds versus the bad deeds. A lot of Muslims, what they think that, which is good, their main focus is to make sure I don't make sins. That's excellent. But they don't realize that also more important than that is to make sure you do more good deeds as much as you can. The shaitan understands this very well. The shaitan knows if he work in you and make you commit sin, he got one. But if you do good deeds, you do 10 and more. So if the shaitan can stop you from doing good deeds, you lose 10 or more. He knows that it's a better deal for him to prevent you from doing good deeds than to convince you to make a sin. He's winner at that point. And you became a great winner if you work this way. You try to avoid sin as much as you can, but your focus, your main focus is to increase your good deeds. My message is not to, a'udhu billah, belittling or making or undermine the dangers of sins. No, my message should resonate with each and every one of us tonight or today is about the importance of increasing your good deeds. Anytime you have a chance to say subhanallah, say it. Anytime you have a chance to donate, donate. Anytime you have a chance to read Quran, read. Anytime you have a chance to say salam alaikum, to smile, to help, to lend a hand, to be part of every good deeds and good opportunity that you see in front of you, be part of it. Because that accumulates. So when you come on the day of judgment, you will be so proud of yourself, so happy, so comfortable. And nothing can help us to achieve their goal, like the month of Ramadan. So take full advantage of it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يعيننا وإياكم على صيامه وقيامه وعلى ذكره وشكره وحسن عبادته وأن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا وأن يرحمنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم اعف عنا وتولنا في من توليت وعافنا في من عافيت يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أنزل بركتك على هذا المسجد وأهله يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. أنزل عليهم رحمتك ومحبتك ورضاك وغناك وفضلك. لا إله إلا أنت وعلى أهل هذا البلد يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تغفر لوالدينا وأن تغفر لأزواجنا وقرابتنا وذوي أرحامنا ومن له حق علينا. اللهم وفقنا ووفق المسلمين لكل خير، ووفق كل ساع لخير إلى كل خير يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم ولي على المسلمين خيارهم وأبعد عنهم شرارهم، واجمع كلمتهم على الحق والهدى، وولي علينا خيارنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. وأكثروا من الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذا اليوم الكريم، فإنه من صلى عليه صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه به عشرا، ومن صلى عليه في هذا اليوم أبلغه ملك عمن صلى عليه صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. وقوموا للصلاة يرحمكم الله.